Good morning, coffee drinkers. Today is one of those kind of utility days where I'm going to attempt to do a ton of stuff and still maintain my practice schedule. There are a few things mounting up that I haven't taken care of since I got back. It's kind of admin stuff. It's always a challenge like this when I feel that stuff mounting up that I just simply have to take care of, life stuff that I have to take care of, but I'm still super inspired to practice and I want to make sure I put in the time and put in the hours rather than the minutes. So I'm really going to try and manufacture that time and kind of stay true to the practice regime because it's felt great to be playing every day. But right now it's about 8 a.m., been up for around an hour. It's time to get out, get rolling with the day. A few mundane things, unfortunately, but also some fun things too. All right, first stop, and this is really rock and roll, folks. First stop, dry cleaning. As soon as possible. Any chance I can have it by tomorrow?
Awesome. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Second stop for the day. Grocery store running very low on supplies and I've yet to have breakfast. Hate it when that happens. Just kind of get wrapped up in the week and it kind of bypasses you and suddenly you look in the fridge and there's like nothing happening. Thank you very much. All right, something I'm terrible at and something I kind of really hate, I hate mess, but I also get so wrapped up in work and practice and all those things and sleep and all the rest of it that I let it slide way, way too often. I let it go so far and then I get super OCD about it for like 5 minutes and just go through the apartment like a tornado and clear it all up. But point in case, we had Indian food last night. The kitchen is not, it was not good either. Chelsea chose wisely. I chose poorly. But yeah, case in point, kitchen is an absolute disaster. Time to do something about that right now. Feeling way better about the vastly reduced amounts of mess in my kitchen. I can actually move in here now. Do me a favor, guys. I want to do a pedal episode, like a dedicated Q&A and kind of exploratory episode of the vlog dedicated to pedals. It's not going to be tomorrow because tomorrow I have a gig with Bob's band at the Baked Potato with a completely different band. Sean and Roslyn are out for this one. So we're going with Teddy Campbell and Ty Bailey and Dave DeLome. Three musicians I know but have never worked with. So tomorrow's vlog is going to be kind of about working with people for the first time that you really admire, that you haven't done before, and kind of how that works. But maybe the day after tomorrow could be the pedal vlog. So leave me some questions specific to, I guess, my pedal collection, specific to questions you have about, I don't know, maybe delay or compression or fuzz or distortion or whatever it is. And let's go for it. Let's try and do a big dedicated vlog just to pedals. I know I went over my collection a little bit a couple of months ago, but I thought it'd be interesting to take some direct questions and really get deep inside some of these pedals because I see them. I see the pedal questions coming up here and there, and they pop up on Instagram and Facebook and on the vlog, of course, on YouTube. But in 2 days' time, let's do that. Leave me some questions in the comments below this video all about pedals. And speaking of pedals, one I won't be featuring in the pedal vlog in 2 days' time is the Earthquaker Devices Arpanoid. Thankfully, really thankful that Amazon have a great returns policy, and it's brand new. I only took it out of the box once, so it's eligible for a complete refund. I did try and initially put it up on Craigslist and you know, put it out on Instagram that I was selling it. Not a single person looked at it, and I think maybe I just didn't get the memo before I bought this, and everyone else knew that it just doesn't do what it kind of says it does in the title and in the description. So, the Arpanoid, armed with a return slip, some clear plastic tape, is going back to Amazon today. All right, I'm even managing to catch a little bit of Wimbledon on the TV. Quick update on the time, it's still only 9:15, got a ton done. The Arpanoid, ready to go back, packaged up. And I'm gonna get like 15 or 20 minutes practice in right now. And that's a good one for me, like to get 15 or 20 minutes in early, kind of get my mind in the mode of playing and keep that keep that inspiration going throughout the day. It can be kind of easy for it to drop off, for the kind of the motivation to practice to drop off a little bit. And I hate it when that happens. You know, you wake up all fired up to practice, then you have to do a ton of other stuff, and then by the time like 2 or 3 o'clock in the afternoon rolls around, you're just not into it anymore. So I find that this like 15 minutes, 20 minutes in the morning before I get out of here, I've got to be somewhere at 10 o'clock so I can get in 15, 20 minutes now and head out of here at 9:30. That's great. That really sets me up and kind of keeps a few things. Hopefully I'll come across a new thing that I can then be thinking about during the day. Who knows? That's, you know, maybe, maybe not. But the fact that I'm getting my hands on the instrument early in the day, and then that gives me a little bit more consistency throughout the rest of the day. The day doesn't end up being one-sided with just gym and tennis and then a tiny bit of practice, or just admin and running around and a little bit of practice. Actually, I get way more accomplished this way. Next stop is the racket doctor. Get some fresh string and some rackets ready for my hit today. Hopefully these will last me the rest of the week of training at the club. Can I get 2 of 54, please?
54, last name?
G-W-I-Z-D-A-L-A. All right, it's time to say goodbye to the arpenoid.
Drop them off?
Yeah.
You see us right on that silver racket there.
Okay, great, thank you. Hey, I've got 2 Prestige Pros, yes. And a pair of Vapors, maybe those, yeah.
They felt correct. What string is this one?
That's Prince.
Is it the Beast?
Beast, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Size 12.
Yes.
Correct?
Yeah. Time for one of my favorite parts of the day now. Just getting to the gym. Cramming it all in. It's still only 10:45. So I got a gym session now for an hour. A little rest and recovery. Then an encore tennis session for 90 minutes. So very important here. Need your prediction for the champion of Wimbledon right now. We're only in the second round.
I think that Roger Federer will win.
You think Roger?
Yep.
GL?
I'm gonna go with Federer.
You're gonna go with Federer? Oh man, my guy. See, this guy's isn't a freak. And this guy over here used to be a bit of a Nadal fan. But they all come around in the end. They all come back to the GOAT.
I still hate Federer.
The reality comes out. He doesn't. Federer's like possibly the most likable human being on the planet, but. Wow. All right.
What's up, Janek?
Hey, man. How you doing?
Good. You?
Right.
Good.
Solid hour in. Feels so good. Listen to Sting, Bring on the Night. Haven't heard this record in a long time. Pretty awesome. With Kenny Kirkland and Omar Hakim, Daryl Jones, The Munch. And Branford Marsalis, Children's Crusade, maybe one of my all-time favorite saxophone solos. I was gonna say pop saxophone, but saxophone is pretty badass. A little bit of recovery and roll now and stretch, and then up to the court to hit for an hour and a half. Today is rocking. My opponent for the day has just arrived, Cortez. Now we're gonna go at it in the midday heat. Fucking crush them. Really easygoing coach we have here. We don't call him the terrorizer for nothing. Had a really good 2-hour match. Lost 6-3, 7-6. But one of the best players in the club, so I was happy with that. Really feeling good. And it's still only 3 o'clock. Time to go home and really start the music work day. So far, really balanced. Couldn't be happier. This is like really good. I'm glad to get this on video. This is like, it's a really good example of like a productive day so far. It's kind of tough to leave the club. It's always great fun on court with these guys.
Undeserved.
There's nothing like positive reinforcement when you're coaching young athletes, young musicians, it doesn't matter.
Undeserved.
The original Mr. Motivator right here. Mrs. Snap Queen, Mr. Undeserved, and Mr. Motivator. What a crew.
Undeserved.
What a crew. I'm not even going to try and pretend. It would have been so much easier to come home right now. Been training really hard. Played a match, I'm totally exhausted. Would have been so much easier just to grab a protein bar and do the quick fix, you know what I mean? But I'm gonna try and stick with the routine, make a smoothie, get some fruit inside me, just put a little bit of fuel in the tank before I really start to cook. Okay, that really did only take about 60 seconds to do, and the payoff. Is incredible. And so we come to the most, I guess, musical chapter of the day's proceedings. It's been jam-packed. Freaking awesome day, I gotta say. Normally you guys only see like a little 20-minute chunk of kind of the music element of it. The music element is always happening, but so are all those other things, those real life things from dry cleaning to grocery shopping and all that stuff that we all have to go through. And kind of true to what I was feeling this morning when was it 7:30, 8 o'clock or something, when I got to practice for about 15 minutes and play with that groove, I'm still feeling, this is like 12 hours later, I'm still feeling really kind of psyched to be practicing. And I grabbed my bass, I switched it right before I switched the camera on. I just put my fingers on the instrument. The first thing I played was the interval of a fifth, F and C. I'm gonna see what comes out of that. And that's generally how I kind of start a practice routine, unless I have something specific to work on. Like if I'm learning music for a tour or for a show, or you know, like some of the chord book stuff, then I'm really working on that. But right now I'm just kind of loose for like half an hour. I've set myself, you know, it's not hours. I had planned to practice for hours today, but so much other stuff needed to be done. But now I'm setting myself like half an hour, relaxed, try and get in flow, try and find something musical. I don't have anything that I have to be doing, so anything can happen right now. And it seems to be starting around this kind of this F and C, this fifth idea. Beeping sound is my better half checking in, and I am a little ridiculous. She's telling me her brother enjoyed what I sent. That's awesome. It's just awesome that Chelsea makes it in the vlog today. Most important thing, that's making my, it's making me smile. You see, I'm smiling even now because I get a text from her. So I'm not going to bore you with the details. I will be right back. All right, I'm back. I totally don't feel like playing the F loop anymore. I don't know. As I was kind of going through it and making up that melody, it hits me sometimes where I'm just like, am I into this or am I just forcing it because it's there right now? It's tough for me to strike that balance sometimes. I don't know. I still don't have the magic answer for when it's time to give up the idea and move on to the next thing. No idea. And sometimes I beat an idea to death a little bit too much. And then I think I remember some ideas that I didn't work on enough. So it's definitely room for improvement in terms of efficiency when it comes to developing ideas. But something tells me that's just not the one for today. I just thought for 1 second about, I have a gig with Bob Reynolds tomorrow night, Baked Potato. We're gonna be an awesome band. And I'm just, that kind of flashed through my mind like, ooh, suppose I should look at some of that music and playing with new musicians and all that kind of thing, boom. But it also, for some reason, flashed through my mind, and bear in mind, me and Bob used to be roommates really long time ago. When he graduated Berkeley, it was the same time I quit Berkeley, and we moved to New York together with a friend of ours, Nick, a trombone player, and we lived together in Queens. And so long tones, between a trombone player and a saxophone player, long tones were definitely a thing that was featured on the daily listening menu as a roommate to two horn players. And that just flashed by me. I was like, oh, long tones. Do we really do that as bass players very much? Like, do we practice things that are so simple and so kind of rhythmically sparse? Like, I don't think I do that very much at all. And why not try that? Why not really work on tone production? I mean, we can play a long tone and the waveform kind of dies and we don't have that much sustain. We don't have that ability to blow air through the instrument like a horn player does and make that note last, you know, probably 4 or 5 times as long, even more with circular breathing. So maybe our version of long tones can be kind of stuff that's not so dense in terms of the rhythm. Depending on your tempo, maybe it's half notes. And just concentrating on the tone production of each note and I'm only plucking with one finger on the right hand. I rarely do this. I know I did this a long time ago, but I rarely do this now. And I missed one, there we go. So even at this slow tempo, playing almost diatonic between two chords, kind of basically 5-1 in A minor, there's a potential to miss notes. Of course, I'm talking to you guys as well at the same time. But I'm hearing the melody I'm playing right now. Right there on that octave. I really visualized that. I saw something high. There was definitely an image that went with that note, and it was like, it was something raised up. It wasn't a hill, it was maybe a gantry, but there was definitely a visual association with that note, with that destination before I played it. And especially at this tempo, the visualizations can be quite, for me anyway, can be quite vivid. You know, there's not so much information passing, like screaming by like a super busy street or something that you're trying to cross. It's pretty pedestrian. It's like walking on a path through the woods at a slow pace rather than being in the middle of a city and being all kind of chaotic. So when I went from this E to that E, it was definitely like a visual thing. And I had this vivid picture of like a metal gantry like up high. Don't ask me why. There's no rhyme or reason for that. But it may be worth practicing something that slow. Like I'm basically playing between A minor and E, like a 5-1, 1-5. And really feeling each note, trying to make really emotional choices rather than theoretical or technical choices about these notes. And through that is arriving a lot of visualization. And that's great preparation for, I think, playing in tune, playing in time, having great tone, having great sound, being able to anticipate that a split second before it happens and being completely okay with the outcome. I think that's huge. You know, really just dealing with what's going on here technically, that we all do every time we pick up the instrument, but then being completely okay with the outcome, which is the reaction to our action. Our action being some sort of technical thing here, and the reaction being this sound that comes out of the instrument or the amplifier or whatever you're playing. I saw it the second time there as well. Even when it was a little more dense, even when it was a little more rhythmically dense and there was a lot more going on. And I don't think there's anything wrong with having associations. Like I sometimes associate kind of colors with notes, and like certain chords I associate with an image sometimes, you know, and definitely I associate different chords and different tonalities with very specific emotions that are personal to me, that those are personal experiences. That's not something that's general, that everyone would experience the same way. But it's worth digging into that, I think. Maybe that's what today's, you know, the bulk of today's practice routine for me is about. Maybe that's something you can start thinking about putting into your practice routine. Do you hear a gantry when you play? Do you see a gantry when you play an octave like that? Do you see something high? And I feel something wet there, like some like a dungeon or something. When I go down, it's quite dark. I see an arch, and I see like stone with moisture on it and moss. It's kind of weird. It's something I haven't really checked into that much before. I think it's probably always been there. It's definitely popped up from time to time, but I'm actually experiencing that in real time right now with the instrument. That's kind of awesome. That's a huge win. That's way better than our little F vamp from earlier on. This is real information. This is great feedback. This is stuff I can kind of put into the process and improve my learning process with. So hopefully you can grab onto some of that and insert it into your practice routine, populate your practice routine with it. So today's vlog is totally done. I wanna get into this. I wanna switch the camera off and get way, way into this. And I will see you guys tomorrow for the Bob Reynolds gig at the Baked Potato with this new band, this kind of one-off thing while Sean and Roslyn are out of town. And I can't wait, playing with a bunch of people I haven't played with before, but know their music, that's always awesome. Tomorrow's vlog is gonna be kind of cool. They're all kind of cool. I hope you know this, like they're all kind of cool for me. Like I look back on the vlogs, I'm like, oh, that was that, whoa, that happened, I played that note, or I saw that person, I went that place. I don't think I can put into words successfully enough how important it is for me to make this movie every day and share this stuff with you. Like this does immense things for my process and for my playing and for just my ability as not only a musician but as a human being. And if I can impart something to you guys, that's awesome. There's been some amazing feedback, so thank you for that. And you know, just thank you. That's all I wanna say really. It's a really long-winded way of saying thank you for sticking around, checking it out, being a warrior and following the vlog every day. I appreciate that more than you will ever know. And long may it continue. So today's vlog is done. We'll see you guys tomorrow.